In my last video, I have explained about instrumentation of flame photometry. In this class, I am going to discuss about the nebulometry and turbidometry. Okay, in this class, I am going to explain the basics and principles of nebulometry and turbidometry. Okay, let's see. Here, metry is nothing but measurement. Okay, you keep in mind, here, what is the basic concept involved in nebulometry and turbidometry? Okay, here nebulometry and turbidometry are the techniques of analysis that are closely related to the calorimetry. You keep in mind, these both nebulometry and turbidometry are closely related to the calorimetry, because the instrumentation of both the instrumentation of calorimetry is similar to the nebulometry and turbidometry. Here one time in the GPAT, one question was asked that here nebulometry and turbidometry both methods are related to the following methods. In the option that chromatography, spectroscopy, chromatography, colorimetry, and electroanalytical methods, like the options are given. So you need to choose calorimetry is the answer. Okay, closely related to the calorimetry method. Okay, both nebulometry and turbidometry are based on scattering of light, based on the measurement of scattering of light by suspended particles in the solution. Both nebulometry and turbidometry are based on the measurement of scattering of light. You keep in mind, scattering of light by suspended particles in the solution. Okay, here scattering can be done by which one? Suspended particles in the solution, nothing but suspension. Okay, here however, these two techniques differ only in the manner of measuring of scattering radiation. The difference between both nebulometry and turbidometry is only one thing, that is the measurement. Okay, the manner of measuring of scattering radiation means the angle where which we are measuring the scattering radiation, that is the difference. The manner of measuring of scattering radiation, that is the difference for nebulometry and turbidometry, that we will see now. Okay, here let's say the principle of nebulometry and turbidometry. Here principle, first you can see the definition of nebulometry. It is a measurement of scattered light as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Okay, what is meant by nebulometry? It is a measurement of scattered light. Okay, it is a measurement of scattered light as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. That is the thing. Here in nebulometry, what we are measuring, scattered light has been measured. Okay, that has been a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Then how we will measure scattered light? Let's see. When a beam of light is allowed to pass through sample solution containing suspended particles. First, we need to allow the beam of light is allowed to pass through a sample solution which consists suspended particles. The amount of radiation is scattered by the particles is measured at any angle, usually 90 degree to the incident beam. Okay, the amount of radiation scattered by the particles present in the solution is measured at any angle. Measured at an angle, usually which one? 90 degree. This is important. 90 degree to the incident beam. But suppose here, this is the incident light which is falling onto the sample. Okay, here sample solution contains suspended particles. Here it will scatter the light. Okay, whenever radiation falling onto the sample cell, it will scatter. Okay, the suspended particle will scatter the light Okay, this it will, in the nebulometry, the scatter light measurement will take place at 90 degree to the incident beam. Here this is the incident beam. Here this is the measured light, scatter light. Here detector is placed to the 90 degree to the incident beam. So scattering of light measurement takes place 90 degrees to the incident beam. Okay, that is the thing. Okay, here the amount of radiation scattered by particles is measured at which angle? 90 degree. Very important. 90 degree to the incident beam. Okay, at low concentration of suspension, there is uniform scattering. Okay, if you use the low concentration of suspension, here there is a uniform scattering will be obtained. Okay, the intensity of scattered light is depends upon the concentration of the suspended particles. Okay, the intensity of scattered light. Here the scattered light is more means the concentration of the suspended particles is more. Okay, if the scattered light is more, less means the if the scattered light is less means the concentration of the suspended particles also less. Okay, here that is also the intensity of scattered light. It is overall depends upon concentration of the suspended particles. That is the thing.
Okay, the intensity of scatter light can also be measured at any convenient angle, like 45 degrees centigrade, 45 degree, and 60 degree, and 135 degree. This is my this is the 180 here. 45 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 135. Here, scatter light in nebulometry can also measured at 45, 60, 135 degrees. Okay, mainly at 90 degrees angle to the incident beam. This is the important thing. Okay, this is the principle of nebulometry. Okay, simple thing is the measurement of scatter light. Okay, nebulometry involves measurement of scattering light as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Okay, as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Here, this is the nebulometry. Then comes to turbidimetry. Here the name itself indicate turbidity means nothing but high concentration. Okay, turbid solution. Okay, nothing but suspension only. It is a measure of definition. It is a measurement of transmitted light as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Here it is a measurement of transmitted light. Okay, measurement of transmitted light as a function of concentration of the suspended particles. Okay, in turbidimetry what we are measuring? Transmitted light. In nebulometry what we are measuring? Scattered light. That is the thing you need to observe between nebulometry and turbidimetry. Okay, then when a beam of light is allowed to pass through a sample solution consists suspended particles, which consists suspended particles. In the suspension, here particles will be suspended in the solution. Okay, here the amount of radiation transmitted by suspended particles is measured at any angle, usually 90 degree to the incident beam. Okay, the amount of radiation is measured by suspended particles is measured at angle, usually which one? 90 degree to the incident beam. Here we are measuring the transmitted light at 180 degree to the incident beam. Here in nebulometry we are measuring the scattered light at 90 degree to the incident beam. Here these two are difference. Okay, here in nebulometry scattering light is measured. In turbidimetry transmitted light has been measured. Okay, here the nebulometry scattering light is measured at 90 degree. In turbidimetry scattering light, transmitted light measured at 180 degree. How? Suppose if it is a sample, okay, sample solution which consists suspended particles, whenever I have nothing but incident light, whenever incident light is fall onto the sample solution, here it will scatter the light into all direction. But it is impossible to measure the scattering light in all direction. Here we are measuring the transmitted light, as a function of concentration. It will measure at 180 degree to the incident beam. You can see detector is placed at 180 degree to the incident light. Okay, transmitted light measured at 180 degree angle to the incident beam. That is the thing in turbidimetry. Okay, here at high concentration of suspension, scattering is not uniform. So light is scattered in all direction. For suppose if you use high concentration of sample, high concentration of suspension, what will happen? The scattering of light is not uniform. Okay, here it is not uniformly scattered if you use high concentration. Then the light is scattered in all direction. Okay, then what will happen? It is very difficult to measure the intensity of scatter light at all angles. Okay, here for suppose if it is a sample, okay, if it is high concentrated sample, when light is incident upon high concentrated sample, it is scattered at all angles. Okay, here it is very difficult to measure the angles of all scatter light. So for that way, hence intensity of transmitted light is measured at 180 degree angle. So intensity of only transmitted light, this is the transmitted light, measured at 180 degree angle to the incident light. 180 degree angle to the incident light. This is the thing why we are measuring transmitted light. Okay, then this is about principle of nebulometry and turbidimetry. Then choice of method. Well, which method we have to use? This depends upon the concentration. Whether we have to use nebulometry or whether we have to use turbidimetry, it is depends upon the concentration. Okay, then if the concentration of the sample less, then scattering of light is uniform. If the concentration is less means scattering of light will be uniform. So hence it can be accurately measured at 90 degree or any convenient angle. That means 45 degree or 60 or 135, mainly 90. Okay, if this concentration is less means scattering is uniform. So accuracy measured at 90 degree. So that's why nephelometry is the choice of method for low concentration sample. If the question is asked, nephelometry is useful for low concentration suspension, high concentration suspension, or both, here none of the above. Answer will be the low concentrated sample. Nephelometry is choice of method for low concentrated suspension. Because if low concentrated suspension, here the scatter light is uniform. So it is very easy to measure scatter light at a 90 degree angle by using nephelometer or nephelometer as an instrument. Then if high concentrated sample, if we are using high concentrated sample, scattering light is not uniform. Okay, if the scattering light is not uniform means we cannot measure the scatter light at all the angles. Only transmitted light can be measured at 180 degree. Here scattering light is not uniform. Unless uniform, how can we measure? Here, so only transmitted light can be measured at 180 degree accurately. So this makes tachymetry is the choice of method for high concentration. You keep in mind that nephelometry is the choice of method for low concentration. Tachymetry is the choice of method for high concentrated sample. So this is the overall the basic concept of nephelometry and tachymetry. In my next video, I will explain the instrumentation of nephelometer and tachymeter. Okay, thank you. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and share it to your friends. Okay, thank you very much.